Welcome back to Proactive Investors. I'm Karen Tan. We're about to go over to Perth and speak to Pip Darvall. He's the Managing Director of Jindalee Resources. Welcome, Pip.
Hi, Karen.
Now, you're today going to tell us about some results that you've got back from your Nevada project. What sort of testing did you do there and what did you find?
Sure. So, yeah, we've got a lithium project in the US and called McDermitt, and the testing we've been doing has all been about how amenable the material is for the lithium to be leached out of the rock. And so we've been undertaking quite a few tests, and yeah, we're very pleased with the results. The testing's shown that yes, it is relatively easy to extract the lithium, and you know, testing is continuing. But we're very encouraged.
So what's the next stage now of the testing as the year unfolds?
Yeah, so I guess the way we're looking at it is, you know, looking at the whole project in general. So what we've previously been able to demonstrate is the scale. So it's got the potential to be very large. And now we're looking at, well, okay, it's great if it's large, but can you get the lithium out? And so that's what this most recent test work's been able to prove to us, that yes, we can get the lithium out. And it's a relatively straightforward, well-known, industry standard type process to do so. So that's a big step in de-risking the project. So as a junior exploration company, the way we have to approach things, with the funds available to us is to gradually, step by step, de-risk these projects. And this one we've, as I mentioned, demonstrated it can be big. And now we've demonstrated, yes, we can get the lithium out. And so the next steps to de-risk it will be about continuing to optimise how we might extract that lithium in the most cost-effective manner. So we've got a well-credentialed lab working for us in the US and continuing to do further tests on that lithium leaching. And then past the lithium leaching stage, once you get the lithium into solution, the next stage is actually the purification and the demonstration that you can produce lithium chemicals that are useful to industry. And so those are the next steps that we'll be undertaking.
And with this testing, what sort of message does it send to shareholders?
The main message is that, look, we're just to kind of progress the project, de-risk the project just in a sensible manner, using industry standard techniques, because ultimately this kind of project, the scale of it is significant. And so we will be needing to partner with someone with the skills in that kind of chemical processing area down the track. And so for those parties and for our shareholders, we need to de-risk the project, just step by step in the most cost-effective manner possible. So our approach is to look at where we can add value in the cheapest manner possible. And if we can't add value, then we won't progress.
What about any other projects around the globe for Jindalee Resources, or this is your main focus at the moment?
This is the main focus at the moment, but we've also got several projects here in Western Australia that we're working on, in gold and nickel space predominantly. And yeah, those again, we're just sequentially moving those forward. But the main focus is the US lithium one at the moment, and we've got some permitting and approvals that are nearly complete to allow us to undertake the next phase of drilling to again demonstrate not only that it can be large, but that it's the continuity is what we expect as well.
That's good news for the company. We look forward to the next update to see how you're travelling with the project then. Thanks so much for your time, Pip.
Right. Thanks, Karen.
That's Pip Darvall, the Managing Director of Jindalee Resources.